Welcome, I'm Loren Keim. Today we're going to be talking about how to create engaging videos to attract prospects for your real estate practice. I'm going to start by talking a little bit about why video is the hottest ticket in engaging today's consumers. Whether you're trying to build customer trust and loyalty, whether you want to stand out as the local industry expert, or simply effectively market your properties and generate more sales, video is the ticket right now, and I'll explain why right after this. Here's a video by a Coal Banker agent in South Carolina. So this video actually got over 42,000 hits just on the initial version that they put out. Just on the initial version they put out, which is just absolutely astounding. It's been copied and used in several different venues across the country, and hundreds of thousands of people have seen that. Is that something that they might be remembered for? Absolutely. That would take a lot of work. Now, we're not going to go to that until the end, but we'll talk about different kinds of ways how you can improve your image or reputation online and create clients, because that's really what we want to do. A couple of video statistics. Do you know, in 2015, because I don't have the 2016 numbers yet, over 204 million people watched video online every month on some type of digital device. Might have been their desktop or their laptop, might have been their cell phone, might have been their iPad. That's almost 80% of U.S. internet users. And the amount of time users spent online watching video grew 38.5% in only 2 years, according to Nielsen. Two-thirds of all internet traffic globally is video consumption, and this year it's supposed to go up to around 70%. It's just incredible. And in fact, here are a couple of headlines. This one's from Tech. YouTube is crushing cable TV, according to Google. Now, I don't know what's true or what's not true online, of course, but there are claims that there are more people at any given point in time during the day watching YouTube than watching ABC, NBC, and CBS combined. That's astounding. So how do we leverage that? How do we build that into our business? This one's from the Daily Mail. YouTube defeats television in battle for viewers as it pulls in 1 billion unique visitors a month. Absolutely amazing. Now, a couple of statistics that are going to be important to your website. Video content generates, on average, 3 times as many monthly visitors as other content. And websites that have video on them, video content on them, how to sell your house, how to buy a house, how to buy a house with no money down. Websites with video content have 88% more time spent on those pages by visitors to your site. Having video content on pages can contribute to 157% increase in organic traffic from search engines. In other words, if you've got video on your website, the Googles of the world, the Yahoos of the world, are more likely to find your site and rank it higher if you've got that video included. And product videos increase the likelihood of purchases by 85%. Let's be honest. What we want to do is we want to actually see how to put that lawnmower together, or we want to see how to polish some table or something else rather than reading about it. That's what we like to do. Some of the goals we have of using video in a real estate practice, of course, is to do home tours to market and sell our listings. I'm going to show you how to do that more effectively. It's also to generate leads. We want people to call us, whether they're buyers who want to buy something right now, whether they're sellers who look at our videos and say, wow, I've got to hire that agent, they're fantastic. And we've got to create a call to action to get them to do that. Or whether we want to identify people who are thinking about buying and selling in the future and get them to work with us. And of course, we want to build our brand along the way. A lot of things we've got to do, and unfortunately, we've only got 30 minutes. So, types of real estate videos. We're going to talk about home tours or visual tours. We're going to talk a little bit about drones and some stuff with stories and humor. I'll talk about market updates, some local information videos. We call them town tours, educational videos, and how to create viral videos that tell a story or add some humor, and then some ongoing video programs. So let's get started. Video, again, might be your most powerful tool. Google ranking. You might not be able to outrank Zillow or Realtor.com or Central21.com, but a study showed that a video on YouTube is 53 times more likely to rank on the first page of Google search results than your website is. Google prioritizes video results, and the video connection can link back to your site, helping your ranking as well, helping people to find your site and see it. And by the way, Google is rolling out, they've done a soft rollout of what they call their transcription service. And what that means is they actually, almost like when you're talking to your cell phone and having it converted into a text, so you can text while talking, while driving. It takes your video, it creates what you've said in the video into text and packages that with your video that's on YouTube. What's the benefit of that? All those keywords now get ranked as well. And that might push you ahead when people are searching for something online. Very powerful tool, and it's changing rapidly. Now, if you are doing visual tours, and if you are using video as opposed to still photos and stitching them together, we want to show our customers that it really is video. And we'll show you how to do a couple of cute tricks with this. But make sure if you're using a video camera that you have some motion in the film, some motion going on in the background so they can see it's video. Some leaves blowing, some grass blowing. Have a ceiling fan running in the house. Have a tea kettle on the stove. Have a fire in the fireplace. You've got to showcase that it's video, not just still photography. And when you're doing home tours or visual tours, make sure to leverage your seller's relationships. We all know the statistic, right? 64% of our customers right now come as a result of our connections with them. Those people who like and trust us, our friends, our relatives, our coworkers, and our past clients, and those people they refer to us make up 64% of business nationally in the real estate industry. So how do we tap into our friends and relatives, our social networks? And how do we tap into our clients' social networks? Well, I've got an idea. Take your video, create a spectacular video of each property that you put on the market, and then you're going to stick it on Facebook, and you're going to stick it on YouTube, and you're going to go to your seller, and you're going to email them, and you're going to call them, and you're going to tell them, listen, we never know where a buyer is going to come from. And because we never know where a buyer is going to come from, I need your help. I just created a great video on your property. I'd like you to take that video, and down at the bottom, there's a little share button. I'd like you to click share, and if you're on Facebook, post it to Facebook, and please ask your friends to share it as well, because again, we never know where a buyer is going to come from. And share it on your Facebook page, and share it on your Pinterest, and share it on Instagram if you can, and put it on LinkedIn, and any place else you can. And let me tell you something, that will absolutely happen because they want their house sold. And because their house is the one that's being shown on Facebook, their friends and relatives are going to watch the video. And what are they watching? They're watching you. And by the way, some of them have their homes for sale. And some of those people who have their homes for sale have not heard from their agent in the last 3 months, and they see you doing all this stuff for your client. Now, how powerful is that? That's leveraging relationships. Another thing with visual tours. We're going to talk a little bit about using tripods and sliders because you can't hold a camera straight. And sliders help you to really make something look cool, and they're not very expensive. But everybody's asking about drones these days. Yes, the future is now, and drones are incredible. But you've got to be careful. We've already been served by the FAA. You cannot use drones unless you have a drone pilot's license. You have to take a test. It's $150. You've got to study for it. It talks about flight plans and everything else. When you do get a drone, whether you end up getting one yourself or whether you hire somebody to do the drone shots, which gets a little pricey, but they do great jobs, you want one like the one on the screen. These are going to be a lot more expensive than the $50 ones you get at Walmart or Target. At the bottom, you'll see the camera is hanging off the drone. It's not built in. That's called a gimbal it's hanging on. And the reason they have them like that is that it holds the camera steady when the camera lifts off, because no matter what you do with a drone, it's going to shake and shimmy a little bit, because even a little bit of wind is going to affect the flight path of something so small. The gimbal helps to keep it steady so you get a nice, clear, clean picture. And that's why we use this type of drone. That's why they're more expensive, but they're great to use. Now, some of the newer drones are fantastic. Something like this, you can actually program it on your iPhone, your iPad, your Droid. You pinpoint the house or the commercial building that you're listing on your pad, and you press a button for it to go, and you don't steer it. It lifts off and it carefully circles the building, keeping its camera focused on the building. I'll show you an example of that in a minute, which creates some beautiful, crisp video. You can also program a flight path to fly over the building or over the house. You can create a flight path where you go around the property and pinpoint where you want it to target, and then hit the button and it'll follow that flight path. These are fantastic. There's another type of drone that we're using right now that's a very small drone. It's amazing. You put it in the front door of a house, it lifts off and goes through the house, never touches a wall, you don't control it. And with a wide angle lens, it actually videotapes the property it's going through. It's just absolutely amazing. Now, here's a video showing a drone lifting off. See how nice and clear that is? Now, this is actually my computer moving a little slower than it should. This is the type of shot where it's panning around, where it's creating a flight path around the house and showing it from every angle. And this, of course, is a flyover. For time, we cut these short. This is a flyover of the house to show you what that can be done with that as well. And again, going back to a shot where it's circling the house. Is this a little bit nicer, a little bit more effective than anything you're putting on right now? It probably is. And yes, this is going to be more expensive. But keep in mind, your goal is not just to get this person's property out in front of the public. Your goal is really to get more listings. And you're going to get more listings by putting this out here. Now, here's another type of
I was
tour
working.
that I think is a great way of attracting attention. This one had over 40,000 hits as well. And this was by, at the time, a Central 21 agent in Franklin. And let me hit the play button again.
When the call came in, it was my sellers.
Century 21 Commonwealth, this is Lefebvre. Okay, settle down. Stay right where you are. I'm on my way.
There had been a robbery, and they made the logical call to me, their realtor. A nationally recognized community in one of the most desirable subdivisions in the town. It just didn't add up. With
Now
the
notice.
K-8 schools just steps away, the public wanted answers fast.
Thank God you're here.
No problem. I came as soon as I got the call, Dave.
It was steaks. Omaha's. Tender, juicy, and gone. Somewhere in this 2,200 square foot, four bedroom, two and a half bath, hip roof colonial, there was a beef thief, and it was my job to sniff him out. We dusted for prints on the newly finished southern pine floors in the custom country kitchen. The fireplace family room offered hardwood floors and a cozy atmosphere, but no clues. Nothing but chair rail molding and a generous walkout bay window in the dining room. The hardwood floors in the formal living room gave us our first break in the case. Exhibit A. The rubber chicken. Heading upstairs, we checked out the updated full bath with its ceramic tile floors and Corian counter vanity. All four bedrooms were generous in size and offered hardwood floors and ceiling fans. But again, no clues. As soon as we entered the master suite, my gut told me this case was about to break wide open.
Now, does that take a little bit more planning? Does that take a little bit more, oops, sorry. Does that take a little bit more planning, a little bit more work? Absolutely. Is it something that people share because they think it's funny? Absolutely. And he was able to actually tour the entire home, show everything about that property, and be able to tell a story at the same time that held your attention. And that's one of the things we're attempting to accomplish. Now, you don't have to take it to that level, but you can have fun with this as well. You can make it professional, you can make it fun. Okay, let me give you another example, and maybe this is taking it a step too far, but here's another example.
Hi, do you like real estate and baby goats? I do. I'm top producing agent, Spencer Fritz. I thought you were going to throw it. Goats.
Now, this type of video is very entertaining. It's funny. I don't know if it puts him in light of being a consummate professional, but it is something people will share. So there are a lot of concepts people use to try and, or realtors use to try and attract attention. Some of the other ones I've seen, there's at the bottom of the page there, there's Riley LePage. He's a realtor who actually walks through houses and kind of makes fun of stuff as he's walking through. Walks into a two-bedroom condo and says, and this house has not just one bedroom, but two. And then he gets into the pool, of course, and is swimming around in the pool. He shows the weight room by lifting weights. He's entertaining, and he catches attention and gets followers that way. Is it effective in marketing property? I don't know. People know his name. Up at the top, you've got Corgi Realtor Presents. Now, this realtor has her dog walk through the property and talks about the property as the dog's walking through and pretends the dog is the realtor. Again, entertaining, it's something that catches attention. It's one way of trying to attract attention. Is it the best way? I don't know. But there are lots of ways to conduct visual tours and home tours, and I highly recommend drone tours right now, but you can have a lot of fun with tours as well. Second type of video, because of time, is what we call market updates. And they're personally branded updates in the market that make you the local industry expert for current real estate market. And you can create these every week or every month, much like Rick Davidson does for Century 21. You can post them out there, and if you do, don't just stick them online. Send a copy to every person in your database, every person in your contact relationship management software program. Send it to the press. You may get some hits. The problem with market update videos, of course, is that the shelf life is very short. But the benefit to them is that as people in the press see them, they tend to call you for information, they tend to call you for quotes, so you get other benefits out of it. You'll also find that people consider you more of an expert if you're talking about the market rather than just selling a house. Another type of video that has been very, very popular, very successful across the country lately, have been town tours and local information. As people search a particular area, Houston, Texas, Chicago, wherever, they're looking in different areas, video comes up very high in Google ranking. So if you create a short video, I'm not talking about something extensive, but a short video on each small town, each borough, every area that you service, and put yourself in front of the camera, you're going to get ranked higher. People are going to see you talking about the area, and you can finish with a clip about yourself. I'll show you some short versions in a minute. You can stand in front of something iconic in the neighborhood or in the area, talk about what makes that neighborhood or small town great. The videos can be a minute or two long. They don't have to be very long. And then you use what are called B-roll, photos or video of the area. You talk through it, but you're showing scenes in the background. And you go neighborhood by neighborhood to put that together. Let me show you a couple of quick examples. This was done by a realtor in Connecticut.
Hi, Jonathan Carbuti here with Carbuti & Company Realtors, and welcome to our town tour of Branford. What's nice about Branford is it's a bedroom community for New Haven. You're close to I-95. You're about 10 to 15 minutes from New Haven, and you're probably about another hour from New York City. You wouldn't normally think of Branford being along the shoreline as a commuter town, but we actually have a newer train station here that runs right into New York City, and then you connect right with the Metro North line, and an hour and 10 minutes, you're in New York City Grand Central Station. Right now we're in the center of Branford. What's cool about here is that you have the town green that's right in front of Town Hall. You have all these coffee shops.
And then of course I skip right to the end.
Just wanted to thank everyone for joining us here for our Branford town tour. And if you're interested in more information about this beautiful town or you'd like to tour some homes, just give us a call. Thanks for watching.
Now this video was so successful for the realtor who put it together that the competitor had to go out and hire a helicopter, I think, and a professional speaker and put together something very professional. I don't think you have to go to this length, but I'll show you a short clip of it.
Time to set sail and explore the beautiful town of Branford, Connecticut. Perfectly settled along the Connecticut shoreline.
Now again, I don't think I've taken it to this level.
After taking a peek at a day around town, you should note, Being a Branford resident makes it hard not to boast.
Now, will the difference between the first video and that second video make that much of a difference attracting clients? I don't think so. But there are many systems, there are many real estate companies that have videos like this up now, one for each area of town. And each of those videos is separate. They have them on their website, they've got them on YouTube, they rank higher. People can learn about the property, learn about the towns, the boroughs, the neighborhoods directly from the website. It's a powerful tool because people like to watch about something rather than read about something. And when you post these up, you're going to rank higher. Here's another example that I think is fantastic. These are videos that were put up on different neighborhoods. Avondale, 93,000 views. Beverly, 14,000 views. Bronzeville, 15,400 views. Bucktown, 22,000 views. Are your websites getting 93,000 views? This is something that can sell not just the community, but you. That's what you're really trying to tie yourself to. You're the realtor for Avondale or for Bucktown or whatever area you happen to be servicing. Now, you can also create educational videos. We try and figure out what questions are asked the most often. What are first-time homebuyer questions? What special loans are available to buyers? And when you're selling a home, will the realtor buy it? That's one of my favorite ones these days. Each audience has different questions, and you can create a video to address each of those questions that you might come up with, post them on YouTube, and then we're going to do some other things with them as well. How to pre-approve for a loan before you buy a house in Houston. You can create something very simple at your desk in your conference room. Put them together in a series of educational videos, and then build that into your follow-up campaign. If you're not using a CRM, a contact relationship management system right now, you need to be doing that. And when a buyer identifies themselves as somebody wanting to buy a property, send them a series of emails, a series of contacts. In another session, we're talking about how to actually track those buyers using Google Remarketer and using Facebook Pixels. But create a video series and build that into your follow-up because it's a powerful way of communicating with them and showing them yourself as a person rather than just some emails. You might put in shopping for a home, pre-qualifying for a loan, writing an offer, the home inspection process, the settlement, and so on. It's not that hard to put together. Do them one at a time and get them together when you can. And then create educational videos that are targeted at specific markets. How do you buy a house with no money down? What are the secrets to buying a house with veterans benefits, the 10 things you need to know? How do you find foreclosures in Houston, Texas? What's your home worth? Should you sell a house in a divorce? These are targeted messages that you can use. And anything you do, any educational video you do, even if you're building it into your contact relationship management, you've got to have a call to action at the end of each video so the consumer can find you, can lead it back to your website, or that they can identify themselves as someone who wants more information. You want to have that in every video, some way to contact you, some way to click through something. There are also companies and agents that are doing what we call episodic content, ongoing video programs, and that may evolve like a television series with an audience growing with expected content. You can have fun with that. You can do videos on local schools, which again, Google might bring up in a search. You can do videos on the best parts of your area, the best restaurants in your area. And by the way, if you go in, you meet with a restaurant owner and you say, listen, as part of my video series, I want to videotape your restaurant and how wonderful it is. Take some shots of somebody cooking in the background. Do a little bit of an interview with you. Pan across the restaurant and do a short minute and a half video and post it to YouTube. That restaurant owner is going to become your friend and client. And they're also going to share your video and their clients are going to see it as well. And for commercial real estate, you might do an interview series with local business people. It's one way to connect with them. Another targeted audience. Now, when you're putting video together, I want to talk about a couple things real quickly. Obviously, you need an HD video camera. And by the way, you can buy them for $250 at any retailer. But some of the other things you might want are a wireless microphone or shotgun microphone, and I'll show you that in a minute, a tripod, a slider, and maybe a green screen if you're going to film yourself and then put yourself in front of something so you can actually hear the recording inside. Now, let me start with a wireless microphone or shotgun. The problem with an onboard... Let me start with tripod, actually. Tripods. How many of you in this audience think that you can hold a camera perfectly steady and get a nice steady shot? Well, you're wrong. You can't, because there's a pulse in your thumb, so your hands are always moving just a little bit. You're also breathing, so the camera moves up and down. So if you try and hold a camera still and then you play it back, it's going to look like the Blair Witch Project, especially when somebody puts it on a big screen. What we need to do every time is take along a tripod. You can get it for $30 at Walmart or Target or wherever, and attach it to the tripod when you're taking video. Make sure to do that every time. Second item that you need is something for sound if you're going to be talking to the camera. If you're not going to be recording it at your computer, the onboard mic is never going to work to get great sound. A shotgun mic can help because it's directing all the sound coming from the spot where you point the shotgun mic, but they're not perfect. A lavalier mic is probably your best option if you're going to be talking to the camera because it helps to get rid of the sound in the background. I'll show you a quick example. This is a guy changing oil. In the first audio clip, you can't really hear him at all, and he's got a fantastic voice. Let me play this real quick.
What's your favorite part of the job?
My favorite part of the job is doing the oil changes.
And I can't hear him.
Does it take you a long time to do them?
Nah. No, just drain the oil, pull the plug, put the filter in, the air filter, make sure the plug's tight, put the oil in.
Now that's with the onboard camera. Whoops. I messed up here. That's the onboard mic. Now let's have a lavalier on him.
My favorite part of the job is doing the oil changes. I like them.
Does it take you a long time to do them?
Nah. No, just drain the oil, pull the plug, put the filter in, the air filter, make sure the plug's tight, put the oil in, and that's it.
Now it costs you $100, maybe $150 to get a lavalier mic, but if you're going to be doing these types of videos, it's going to be much more effective. Another thing I want to talk about real quick is a dolly track. This is something you can get an automated one, or you can get one that you can slide. A dolly track allows you to put a camera or video camera on one side and slide it carefully across so it doesn't shake, or to tilt it just like so when you're showing something, it looks almost like a drone lifting off. You can actually smoothly lift it up. I'll show you a quick example. This is how they work. Now this guy's using an automated one. But he's panning across a house, of course. Here's another one, even showing the tree in the foreground to actually show that you are using motion. You can see the leaves moving here. And again, he's using an automated one along a track. Now, the one he's using is about $400. You can buy these for about $80 on Amazon that are not automatic. It makes a crisper, smoother picture, and this is where he's tilting it up. Now, hopefully this looks a little bit better than just taking still photos. Another thing you can do is film it very slowly, program it or move it very slowly across. And then when you do your video editing, speed it up, gives it another type of effect. By the way, it's really easy to do this with any video software. And this is using it on the tripod, setting the dolly track on top and just raising it up. Like I said, almost like drones. The way it lifts. Now, how do you put these together? Real quick, last couple of things. If you have an Apple machine or an iMachine, you might want to use iMovie. It's free. On every Windows machine, somewhere in there, you've got Windows Live Movie Maker. You take the clips you put together, you just open it up, you take the clips you put together and you import them, and you put them in order. You can see the order on the screen on the right-hand side. You can even put transitions between them. There's a little button for transitions. If you have an audio track, you can add the audio track at the bottom, just put it underneath, and then up at the top you can share it to YouTube. There's a YouTube button to share it. It's not that hard to do, and that's free software. And a couple little other quick comments. You can also use video as advertisements on other people's videos. Obviously, anybody who's watching YouTube in this room has seen videos where there's a 5-second or a 30-second video before the one that you actually want to watch. You can pay YouTube to put your videos in front. And by the way, it's not that expensive. Create ad videos, and you're going to target those ad videos to anyone watching from this area. So you might want to put into your AdWords campaign or your ad campaign that you are looking for only people in these 5 zip codes that are watching videos today, tomorrow, this month. And those people in those 5 zip codes, we want only the ones who are searching for homes for sale, or searching real estate, or searching how to buy a house. Create lists of search terms, put those all together, and it's going to identify the potential buyers and sellers that are looking at video online. It's going to put your clip in front of it. Also, post these videos on Facebook, of course, and you can use something called Facebook Live Streaming. But, of course, we're a little short on time. So a couple of final thoughts. Let's say you want to do town tours, and you can't because you're not a writer. You can't figure out what to say. You're scared of writing. That's something that stops many agents with psychological paralysis. You can hire a local community writer. There are plenty of them out there that write for small papers. You can run an ad in Craigslist or any place else saying, I need somebody to help me with writing a couple of two-paragraph videos. They might pay. You might have to pay them 50 or 75 or 100 bucks to write content about the area. Or you can go to the local college and get a writing intern. Generally, they're free. Try and get a few of those together and get some paragraphs written, and that's what you're going to say. And good intentions alone won't get this done. Map out a plan of what you want to do with each video. We call them storyboards. Plan out a timeline of what you want to do, storyboards for what you want each scene, put it together, and poof, you've got a video. Thanks very much.